Dear students, hope you are fine and safe. Students, today we'll do the recapitulation of chapter 2 and the chapter name is Changes in Neighborhood and School. What is a change? Change is a process through which something becomes different. Okay, change is the law of nature, students, and as time advances, as time passes, everything undergoes change. From the past several decades also, there has been a significant change in all the fields, in our lifestyle as well. So, first of all, in this chapter, we'll see the changes in the lifestyle. Change in lifestyle. For understanding this, students, let us know what is the meaning of lifestyle. Lifestyle means the way in which people live their life. Okay, the way in which people live their life. So there is a significant change in the lifestyle as well, students, and the change is mainly because of technology. Example, here you can see that this teacher is teaching on the blackboard. But now, since the technology have changed, you can see here that in this image, the teacher is teaching with the help of smart boards. Okay. In fact, students, many schools have now made compulsory the use of tablets in the school. Also, students, now you must have seen that even the small children, they can connect iPad to Wi-Fi. So you can see that there is so much of change in our lifestyle. In earlier times, we used to have a simpler life because we didn't have that much of resources. But now, the lifestyle have advanced because of technology. Second example is that in earlier times, the family used to spend the time together. But now, because of technology, most of the people are busy on their phone. And because of this, personal relations are losing their identity. So, now I hope, students, you must have understood what lifestyle is and what are the changes in lifestyle which have come because of technology. Now, we'll understand that lifestyle comprises of so many other things, right? The food pattern we have, houses, the type of houses, then the clothing pattern, the traditions we follow, and the work culture. So, one by one, we'll learn the changes which have come in all these fields. Right? First is change in food. Children, in earlier times, people used to have the homemade food. But now, there is a significant change. What? That now the children and even the adults, they prefer to have the fast food. Also, children, right? In earlier times, people used to carry lunch boxes to their office. But now, they don't carry that even. What they prefer? They prefer that they will order pizza or some fast food from the restaurant. Okay, and all this, the consumption of fast food and the oily food have led to many problems. Like in children, the children are facing the problem of obesity, and the adults, they are facing the problem of cholesterol. You know, their cholesterol level have increased, and which is leading to health related problems. So these are the changes in food pattern. Now, we'll see the changes in work culture, working pattern, working style. In earlier times, students, the workers, they had to sit in the office from 9 a.m. in the morning till 5 p.m. in the evening. But now, it have changed. Now, the workers or employees, they can work even from their home. and it has made the work style more flexible, right? And now, because of its flexibility, it has become more family friendly. For example, students, you can see that this man is working from his home. So how it has become family friendly? That now he can spend time with his family also. Also, students, he can do some household works also, along with the office work, right? So this is one of the change in work. Second change is outsourcing. Outsourcing is a significant change in our work style. Now we have started outsourcing our work to someone who is more efficient, who can do the work at a more cheaper price, right? So outsourcing have become a significant part, and it is a significant change in the working pattern. Third is changes in clothes. Students, there is a change in the clothing pattern as well. In earlier times, you know, the ladies or the men, the ladies used to wear sari or some traditional clothes, and the men, they generally used to wear the bell bottom pants. But now there is a change in the clothing pattern. Now we are, you know, accepting the Western fashion and the Western trend. So the sari are mostly replaced by jeans and tops, and the bell bottom pants are replaced by jeans. Students, there is a change in traditions as well, right? What happened that in earlier times, the family, they used to worship together, they used to spend time together. But now, the personal relations are losing identity because of technology, okay? So there is a change in traditions. The children are losing the values. The value which the children in earlier times they had, nowadays the children, they don't have that values, right? Because mainly it is because of the change in lifestyle, change in technology. Students, even there is a change in the housing pattern. How? That in earlier days, there were big old houses with a high ceiling. The high ceiling and the ventilators kept the house cool without coolers and or air conditioner, right? And the toilets and bathrooms were separate and they were not attached to the bedrooms. But nowadays, students, what happens that people live in apartments with quite low ceilings and lesser doors and windows. The cooler and air conditioner keep the houses cool. Apartments usually have the attached bathrooms with marble flooring and latest fittings and sanitary ware. So there is so much of change in the housing pattern as well. Now students, what are the reasons for all these changes? We learned that there have so much of changes which have come in the working pattern, in the food pattern, in the clothing pattern, right? So what are the reasons? First is changing school. How? For example, student, you study in Lieutenant Atul Kataria school and your father gets posted somewhere else. For example, he gets posted to West Bengal. And you also have to shift there along with your father. So now, when you shift to West Bengal, you'll be joining a new school. And there, you'll be getting totally a new environment, new teachers and new students, new friends. So with that, because of that, you know, change in the school, you'll get to learn new traditions. Because you'll try to adjust to that environment. And while adjusting to that environment, there will there will be a significant change in your lifestyle as well. Okay, so first reason is changing school. Second is changing classroom. As your classroom changes, for example, earlier you were in 3rd B, but now your classroom, your class has been changed from 3rd B to 3rd D. So in 3rd D, you'll have new students, right? New friends you'll make there. So with that, because of the change in classroom also, the environment will totally change. And in that environment, you'll try to adjust. And when we adjust in a new environment, a change happens in our lifestyle. Students, now let us learn what are the effects of shifting. First example we discussed, that your father gets transferred to West Bengal. So what happens? That earlier you were in a joint family, but now since you have to move along with your father to West Bengal is the state. So now you'll have to move along with your father to West Bengal. You'll be having a nuclear family. Fine. So you leave away your grandparents, your uncle, aunt, your cousins, your relatives. Right. So this is one of the effect of shifting. Second is, this shifting, it can cause happiness and also unhappiness. How, students? How you'll get happiness because of shifting? When the standard of living, it improves. When you get better education at the new place, right? And your parents get new job opportunities, better job opportunities at new place, it will lead to happiness. But how it leads to unhappiness? Since you have to leave your grandparents, your relatives at Gurgaon only. So it is leading to unhappiness because you have to leave them and go to a new place. Now students, we have learned the effects of shifting. So now we have shifted to a new place where? In the West Bengal. So there we have to, adjust. Who makes the adjustment easy? Friends, right? If we make friends there, the adjustment will become much more easier. So students, how to make friends? First rule is to share. You should always share. Then only you'll be able to make the other person your friend. Second is give flowers. Third, be nice. Then fourth is always say please and thank you. Fifth is, students, play together. Right? Sixth is help each other. So we have learned the rules that how to make friends. Now students, you must be thinking that this shifting and all, this change, whether it is good or bad. Let me tell you students, that this change is good. How? It helps us to grow and learn, right? When you shift to a new place, you learn different things. You learn about new people, new traditions, right? New places. And that will help you to grow. It is an important part of our life. See students, in life, nothing is static. Nothing remains for permanent. Change always happens. So that is why it is considered good. Then it creates excitement in our lives that this thing is going to change. And if it's going to change, what will be the next thing? What will be the next form of this thing? So it creates excitement in our lives. Now, when we move to a new place, first of all, friends make easy the adjustment process. But on self basis also, how can we adjust to change on yourself? First is, you should accept the change. Fine. Okay, like example is, okay, you should accept that now you have moved to West Bengal and now you have to study here. You should be patient, because adjustment, it takes time. Thirdly, if you need support, you should seek your family support, right? Because your parents are always there and they will make you understand. They will make you more homely there, right? So these are the three ways how you can adjust to change. Now, student, one of the topic we are going to discuss is gender sensitivity. This is a very important topic, students. Gender sensitivity, it means to be sensitive towards all the genders, be it male, be it female. Okay, so we should be sensitive. Gender sensitivity, it addresses the problem of gender inequality. What is gender inequality? Gender inequality, it refers to health, education, economic and political inequalities between men and women in India. Fine. So when we do gender sensitization, the problem of gender inequality resolves. We need gender sensitivity in two fields. One is related to play and the second is related to work. In earlier times, what used to happen, student, that sports was always been identified with men. Okay. Sports was always identified with men. But now, students, even the women are actively participating in sports. And they have made our nation very proud, despite all the odds. For example, Marie Kom, then, you know, Mithali Raj and Geeta Fogart. So, there has so much of change which have come because of gender sensitization. Then, in the other field which we will discuss is related to work. Students, in earlier times, the jobs of men and women were clearly demarcated. That this particular job is for women. The household works are for women and the outside works, like for example for the army, air force, navy, these were the jobs which were assigned to men. But now, students, things have changed. How? Women are also venturing into all these fields. They are also working as doctors, pilots, astronauts, right? One of the example is Sunita Williams. She is an astronaut. Okay. And even the men are venturing into the fields which were initially being related to females. Like now men are makeup artist, fashion designer, hairstylist. Okay. So with this topic of gender sensitivity, we understand, students, that everyone is equal. And no one should be discriminated on the basis of its gender. Anyone can do any work, right? So students, with this, we come to an end of the recapitulation of chapter 2. I hope everything is clear, students. In case if you have any doubt, you can just message me. Thank you, students. Be safe and stay healthy.